We've just sat down with everybody here now, and you can see they're putting on some of this hump fat, and she just poured oil all over the rice.
They have their setting, they're waiting on some more food.
They're just like waiting for all the side dish coming, then we can start to eat. And the blood, because it's like a live thing, they're gonna mix it a bit of water, and that's the one that they're gonna throw to those families.
Like a blessing.
Blessing. They need some special type of zebu to do some sacrifice, because it's not like all the type of zebu you can use for that.
I just thought about this. They don't have guns out here. So when they dispatch this, are they just gonna jump on it?
Yeah, that's how they do it. They just like jump and.
Today marks the end of our journey in Madagascar. It is all built up to this moment and this day. Behind us, a small herd of zebu. Today we will be witness to a rare tradition in this area.
In this kind of area, a lot of people are trying to move to a different place for work. Every couple of years, they are coming back here to ask some blessing to the ancestor.
It's been 5 years since a zebu was slaughtered in this village. Today, family, friends, and even far-flung neighbors will join together for an event that will feed over 100 people.
To eat zebu, maybe some people can have like a small piece of zebu everybody need to share, but some moment like this doesn't happen like every year.
In Madagascar's countryside, zebu is life.
Down here in this area, if you like really like the real man, like all the girl fell in love with you, you need to fight with those zebu.
Animals were brought here 1,000 years ago from East Africa.
Especially for Malagasy people, zebu take like a special place.
Now, zebu are the most prized livestock on the island.
If you don't have a zebu, then it's like really a shame on you.
It's like having a shitty car in the US. In the US, if you have a piece of crap car, good luck getting a date. Here, if you don't have a zebu, you ain't nothing.
This man here is a zebu seller, and he says he'd sell this one for $280. Not bad.
What is the most prized part of this animal?
That fat part in top, that will be considered for the oldest person in that village.
I was born in 1984. Do I get the fat?
You don't really look that old yet.
Oh, thank you.
There will be no exchanging of money now. The zebu for today has already been selected by the village.
Sir, I appreciate your zebu selling confidence. The secrets of the trade. Thank you for letting us in on all that.
The walk begins.
It must be a male. It need to be like a clean zebu. And what we consider as a clean zebu, when it have like white, head. This one is a kind of aggressive one.
At the village, just a couple hundred meters away, family and friends wait. They've waited 5 years, so just a few more hours will be just fine. Ladies make coffee in today's makeshift outdoor kitchen. Men discuss the official matters of what's to come, and the zebu makes his way to the village and then waits. There is no rushing here. All is mula mula, a Malagasy word that means slowly, slowly. First, the official greetings among elders and laying out the intentions for the day. The younger men are appointed the unenviable task of taking down the zebu. This
They are throwing the water on the zebu. The zebu can cool down and die in a piece.
More words, more speeches, more weight. Blood will be cooked and eaten, but some of it is mixed with water and used to bless members of the community. Finally, prayers, speeches, and blessings subside, leaving us only one higher power that I actually recognize: booze. This time in the form of homemade illegal rum, containing an unknowable percentage of alcohol.
Hey, la ville.
Hey, la ville.
Shots down, time to cook. Over 100 people must eat. Time to work. First, rice, boiled, then wrapped in leaves until it's ready to eat. Next, cassava two ways, boiled till soft, then mashed and combined with crushed peanuts. Or option two, crocodile bullets, shredded cassava, shaped by hand and fried in oil until crispy. Then the grasshoppers. Wait, what?
This kid, he went out and he caught a load of grasshoppers. Are you gonna fry these later? When you fry these, can I have one? Just save me one, save me one.
Grasshopper appetizer on the way. Meanwhile, dozens work together breaking down the zebu into manageable pieces. We're attempting to cook hundreds of pounds of meat in just a few hours. The only way to do that here, boiling. The innards are next.
Oh my God, this is the heart, the lungs here, and down below is the liver. That thing is massive.
Then I stumble upon the most prized piece of the zebu.
What the F? What's going on there?
That's the zebu penis, and this is the zebu fat.
This was the fat hump on the back of the zebu, and right now she's slowly peeling away the skin and the fur. Only the best can prepare this food, and that's why she is here right now. I brought you a lovely gift. You can keep working, it's okay. These are Korean noodles.
I think she will like feel much more healthier than now after eating that.
Well, I'm not sure that it's so healthy, but it's yummy. It's very yummy.
On the sidelines, a dedicated village elder parses out portions of zebu to neighbors who will take it home and share it with their own families. There are no refrigerators here, so now is a pretty good time to eat it. The meat boils, the penis boils, the hump boils. But if you look behind the right tree, you'll find this.
Yo, we found a side party behind this tree. They just started grilling the meat already.
In such place like this, the young people are always trying to make something on its side because the cooking gonna take really long time.
Right, so they're just grilling it straight up. Is there any seasoning?
No, this is just like put salt on it and then grill it. So this is like already the one grilled.
A little bit of fire, a little bit of salt. Perfect. Yeah. You want some?
Of course.
Cheers. Mmm, I don't know what part that is. A little chewy, but the taste is delicious. It's very beefy, but it has a little goatiness to it. It has a little bit of goat flavor. You're a good cook.
My hand, run away.
Dinner is almost ready, but first, an exclusive appetizer.
My man has his little fried grasshoppers here. It's just like a side snack. He catches his own food. He's like, you guys eat the zebu, I'm gonna eat my bugs. You ready? One, two, three. Juicy, a little salty, crunchy, but wow, that's got like salt water inside. I like this kid. Boom, boom, thank you. So far we have rice, we have the cassava mixed with peanut, and then we have some boiled zebu meat. Wow, everyone's gonna get so much meat today. I'm just remembering back to the goose.
They have to cut it in a lot of small pieces because they have a huge family.
Everybody gets a piece, yeah. Good.
This time it's like a feast, so everybody just like make them happy and full. Ewa shamna azwabe. Okay, now we can start.
What were the magic words there?
Round one, mash cassava with a surprising ingredient.
Cheers. Oh, I love that. Just that nice starchy cassava. What is that piece?
This is a banana.
There's banana in here? Let's try it with the banana.
I just like had the banana with the fat zebu meat.
It's not banana at all. That was a tremendous chunk of zebu fat. Not that it's bad, but when you're expecting a banana.
Round two, elephant ear beans.
Do you know as well the elephant
the
ear?
Hell?
The vernacular name, like English people call it the elephant ears. They just like open it and get the seeds inside. Then they eat the seeds of this afterwards. Wow. So it's like a beans.
A thin film on the seed is removed using soot. It's then boiled with a healthy dose of zebu meat.
Did they put some meat in here too? I like how they just mixed a little meat into everything. These are cool. I've never seen this before. First time. It's like a really starchy kind of lima bean, but softer outside.
Like really meaty beans.
Now, finally, it's time for the zebu.
Our day has built up to this moment. Let's try it out.
I was expecting it to be much more harder than that, but.
Me too. But you can really feel the layers, the fibers of muscle and tissue here. I gotta say, the taste exceeds my expectations. This is so much animal to cook for so many people in a short time.
Yeah.
Just on a, hi there. Just in a handful of pots, in an outdoor little kitchen like that. Oh, they brought more meat, yeah.
Oh, this is the zebu heart.
You wanna try it? Here we go. Oh, that is a great texture, man. Look at that, look how juicy it is. This is just by boiling. A little bit of like gamey goat flavor. It's not like 100% like beef, but I can say zebu tastes like zebu. It's something you have to try for yourself.
This experience is almost complete, but if we want to try the prized zebu hump, we can't wait for it to come to us.
It's taken a long time to cook it. When you turn it a bit, you can see as well all the oily.
Holy, that's all just oil? Is that just cooked down?
Yes, they're gonna eat the meat and take a bit of oil on the rice.
Should we try it? Okay. Wow, that was too big of a bite. That is so rich. It's intense. You're not talking at all.
I'm sorry, but it's too delicious. I can't handle it.
Zebu, like, I've never even heard of it until I came to Madagascar. And now when I leave, how am I gonna ever have it again?
You just need to come back.
Deal.
The more I travel, the less certain I am about what makes a good life. Food, shelter, a strong drink here and there. We all know what it takes to survive. But the answer to what creates a fulfilled life changes from country to country. Some people here don't have much, but many, the people I've met along the way, have everything they need. What I know for sure is that this country has left a lifelong impression on me, and one I will not soon forget.
Joel, my man, thank you so much for this whole experience. You've been an incredible tour guide.
It was a real pleasure, and thank you as well. I really appreciate it.
This whole experience wouldn't have been possible without Ramar Tour. Joel's a part of that. Actually, you could book a tour with them and have Joel be your tour guide. It would have been so much more difficult to make this trip happen, but through them, they made the perfect itinerary. Also for you guys, this video was made possible by One Trip Vietnam. One Trip is the highest rated tour company in Vietnam, doing tours from north to south in all major cities, including Hanoi, Nha Trang, Da Nang, Hoi An, and Saigon. You can experience food tours, adventure tours, and more.
To learn more about One Trip, check out the links in the description down below. I will see you next time. Peace! Yeah, buddy! Woo! You are a rock star. That was incredible.